sister, I after your depart, and may the on your. Forgive me. Now I will cross over to the other side of the dream.
Thank you. Well, once its piercing song shattered the mirrors and trinkets in my tomb, let its wail now grant light. Zeta, awakener of the desert, ignite these five lightless eyes. These millennia of torment, my punishment, thread through my bones like poison. My forbidden passion is my penance. My golden virtuous strength armors me. I let this happen. I let this ardor grow inside me. But only the miracle giveth. Only the miracle taketh away. That governs my awakening has been struck. I must end thy irreverent intention, penitent one. And so, the long night is severed. Dawn cometh!
Thank you.
penitent one in sleepness, carrying the guilty soul we have been entrusted with. I, Crisanta, in penance. And thus shall your... That sword you wield, the High Will sing that I must escape the kiss of its steel, as it is wholly tainted by the heresy of its bearer. The Great Ones, from the Eternal Processions, demand that I should battle until I draw my dying breath. The Three. The High Voices proclaim that your execution cannot be delayed. So I fear. Not while their voices still echo. Not while their silence endures. By the miracle! This pain that I feel, it is deeper, more ancient. The guilt you carry has broken something inside of me. My faith, my soul, is wounded. I will now walk to the chapel where it all began. Where the first kneeling took place. Your first step towards atonement. Now leave me alone with my deep wound.
In my dreams, I heard, guardian of the miracle, I am the hands of bloodied, but nothing I know, apart from your calloused no, I know nothing of you. Now may your sword full of gillet them hurt and march in procession. I curse you forever. I bless you forever. The mirror in which you now you see me awoken as the son of the true miracle.
You have freed His Holiness from his afflicted torment. And now he walks by the old processions on the other side of the dream, the cradle of the grievous miracle, the final relic. The grail of blood and gold, that first relic, is here. At the top of the Ashen Mountain, next to the Turn Throat, and now, your final communion with the miracle. Only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart. are. My crimson figure and you on this side of the dream. The miracle has turned me into a sentinel of its sacred home. This is my new calling. What do you hope to find here that is not the blinding gray light that tempers our wounds and the vast horizons that extend? The path of paths has ended, and with it, so too has your pen. Now let your body, like mine, be bathed in blood. This will be your final resting place, but no one will be able to watch over you. There is no point in recoiling from the desires of the all-knowing and all-powerful. My final task is completed. I will go, and so too will all those who loved me. Now I will sink down here, in this land of clouds, in this realm of dust and glimmering lights.
The Guardian has fallen. The final truth awaits you. The final out. Go forward now, through the embroidered mantles towards the light.
Penitent one, who comes into our presence.
Bringing guilt to the most sacred of places, to the most forbidden of temples.
Breaking all laws, and thus desecrating His Holiness Himself. We are the High Wills.
For there is no miracle that does not stem from our desire.
That is not our reflection.
That is not our word.
The word that was first made flesh, and then sanctified. Penitent one, does not the pale, still light of this vast horizon,
of this procession, more ancient than us, that extends out before you without end nor beginning,
of this brotherhood of grieving souls, held captive by their own condemnation,
this is the path of the ancient processions, the kingdom that the miracle wove from threads of dreams. A domain where faith would unite in one single uninterrupted act of adoration.
That would give us light and time.
That would make us eternal.
And higher reaching than the sky itself. You have come to this place to atone for your sins, to put an end to this work.
Destroying our flesh that once was word, and now is but silence.
Making us cast down our eyes, leaving the miracle bereft.
And so the last of our wills is your eternal condemnation. In life and in death, in hunger and in thirst, in sleep and in wakefulness.
Buried under layers of ash, the ash of your flesh, bones and sinew.
Execrated in visage, forgotten in name, forever and ever.
There is no penance that can exonerate this sin. It is the price to pay for the ultimate blasphemy.